people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
Freedom! Seriously, I have a child who is a junior at the University of South Carolina. I have twins that are juniors at Sherrill High School. When they graduate in 2020, my husband and I will be moving to the Columbia area, where he has taken a job recently, and living near Lake Murray, where I think we can maybe like boat around a little bit, cook out, grill, and do a little fishing. Other than that, enjoying all my family being together and closer to everybody is going to be great. And going on our still family vacations every year is even going to be better. So enjoy yourself.
And I would like to say that I'm going to miss my special friends that I've been working with. And I also am going to miss my BFF CPI friends, Jamie Brown and Stuart Wallace, Care, Welfare, Safety, and Security. But really, special education has always been my heart. And I just want to say that Charles Gibson, who is a former co-anchor on Good Morning America, always said that we measure success by the dignity of the challenge. So I hope that my time here as an educator and autism coordinator, that I have lessened that challenge for some of these special needs children, and that they could be successful as they go forward. And I just want to say thanks for the memories, CCSD.
I do a lot of fishing, a lot of this and that, and I'm a sticking out here at the end during the summer, and that's it.
Hi, this is Tim Harris here at CRMS, where I've taught the past 5 years. Prior to that, I taught in North Carolina in lower elementary in a Christian school, and moved south when I married my beautiful wife Jan, who lived down here. So I want to thank her for being an encouragement to me as I moved south and got back into public school teaching. A special thanks goes out to the administration here at CRMS, New Adams principal, and Travis Rivers, assistant. I want to say also just a shout out to those fellow retirees this year, and good luck and best wishes to you. As we look toward retirement now, my wife and I look forward to spending a lot of time at home there, maybe a little traveling. Most of all, what keeps us busy is our grandkids. We have 8, ranging from Madison, who will be graduating in a couple weeks to high school, down to little 1-year-old Ella up in North Carolina. So again, best wishes to the fellow retirees, and just prayers for those educators that will be carrying on in the fall. God bless.
Ms. McBride took real good care of me. She made sure I ate every day. And spoiled me to a certain extent. I will truly miss Miss Vivian. She is the epitome of a hard worker. She cares deeply about her staff, as well as the children at New Heights Middle School, and we're gonna miss her for that.
After 28 fun-filled years, I'm leaving Ruby Elementary and all of these precious babies to go and work at the Flippin' Vintage Marketplace in Chesterfield, located at 1307 West Boulevard. Come see me for your latest in home decor, antiques, farmhouse furniture. Stop by and visit. I will make you a deal. And I wish Miss Stephanie Ramirez the best of luck in room 102 at Ruby Elementary School.
What I'm going to miss most when I retire is the children. The children mean a lot to me. I love to come to school every day and see their smiling faces. I love when they succeed at learning something. I love seeing the lights they come on. They are kind and most forgiving. They tell me that I can sing well. I know I can't sing well, but that they make me feel better when I sing. And I'm also going to miss my Sherrill Primary School family. They have been really supportive of me, especially for the last 4 years. And for that, I thank them all.
When I retire, I plan to stay up as late as I want, sleep as late as I want, and go whenever I want. I have a list of places and things that I want to do, but I think most of all, I'll have the opportunity to spend unlimited time with my husband of 48 years, my 5 great, wonderful, perfect grandchildren, and also their amazing parents.
After retirement, I am going to travel for a moment. And once I finish traveling, I'm going back into the ministry full time. I am a pulpit supply pastor for the United Methodist Church. And I think I shall also work with the children in my community where they need help. Not often, but occasionally.
Okay, once I retire, I'm going to really get involved with my community. I'm not going to go home and sit. There's a lot of awareness stuff that need to be brought to the community. A lot of our leaders in our communities, especially the older one, has passed on. So I want to give back to my community because I wouldn't be where I am today if it hadn't been for folks that's already out in the community helping me get to my goal. And that was my biggest purpose of coming back home and getting into the education system. And even when I was in law enforcement, give back. And, you know, that's one of the biggest things we're missing in our community right now.
As of June
3rd,
I'm going to deliver my grandbaby and from there and enjoy the rest of summer. Then I'm planning on coming right back to work.
What I'm going to miss about Ruby Elementary School is staff and students. This quickly became my home when I came to Ruby. And all the staff just took me in up under their wings and never had a problem with anyone. And all of them have been so, so nice to me. Fell in love with every student. Each one is precious, and I'm really going to miss them. With that being said, what I'm going to do when I retire, I've waited 10 years for a grandbaby, and the Lord saw fit to send me one. Not only that, I have a 18-month-old grandson, and I have a granddaughter on the way. I will be retiring, playing nanny, and taking care of my grandbabies. And I know that I'll enjoy every bit of it. Thanks, Ruby Elementary, for being my home.
Hey, everybody. My name is Rebecca Tolson, and yes, I am retiring after 28 years of wonderful service with Chesterfield County, and I have been with Chesterfield County the entire 28 years. I do plan on teaching in North Carolina for hopefully 5 more years, maybe more, but I also plan on helping my husband work in his nice smelly chicken barns, and hopefully my family and I will travel, take the time to travel a lot more than we have been in the next several years. So I plan on enjoying my retirement, and I hope everyone else plans on doing the same.
My plans at this time is to just enjoy, open a door to a new journey of my life, to mostly spend with my husband, my children, and my grandchildren. Truly, I'm going to miss Chesterfield Intermediate School, my school family, but most of all, I thank God for allowing me to come this way and to meet all my interesting people that I have worked for. And it gets a little emotional at times, but I thank God for opening up this venture.
I really don't really know what I'm going to do. I have no really good plans. The only thing I know I'm doing is spend time with my family, spend lots of time with my grandchildren, and my dad is kind of sick, so I suspect I've been taking a lot of time up with him. But As far as doing anything special, I don't have any plans, just enjoying myself.
Mr. Witt has been an amazing asset to New Heights Middle School, especially in the exploratory department. She has worked for several years in education, and as of now, she's retiring. We will miss her. I will miss her. She took me under her wing and affectionately calls me her other daughter.
Hi, I'm Myra Collier. I would like to spend more time with my feet in the sand and the salt water in my face down at Little River, South Carolina. And I would like to spend more time with friends and family. I have a daughter in New Orleans, so it'll be fun to visit there more often. See our little three-year-old grandson. I like to read, so I'll enjoy just sitting back doing more of that. And I'd like to travel. My husband and I have some pretty big plans to go out west and see a lot of the country we haven't seen before.
I'm going to be going on vacation and going to Florida with my grandkids and my kids, and I'm going to DC with my sisters and my brothers, and I'm going on a cruise, and I'm going to be doing a little bit of everything, and I'm just going to sit back and enjoy going to church, sing on the choir like I always do, just relax. I'm going to just relax myself and enjoy myself.
Ms. Jordan, I'm having an awful time trying to find somebody to replace you. I know you worked hard, but I got this contract for you to work for one more year, teach you just for one more year while I'm trying to find the replacement.
You are crazy. I wouldn't dream of staying another year.